Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to ask, how much is my app worth? Okay, so today I want to answer a question that came in all the way back from episode 291 from Bart Rocca, who said, great video, Eric. Thanks. Could you please do one titled, How Much Is My App Worth? And that's a really good question. You know, I thought this morning, I read it this morning, I thought, yeah, that's the one I wanna answer today. But then the more I started thinking about it, the more I wasn't quite sure how to answer it. Of course, there's two ways to think about the worth of your application. There's a worth to your users and there's a worth to you. So to the users, you know, and like how much you should charge and everything, that's always an important thing and you should always be playing with the prices, right? Try to go high and see if you can still make the same amount as you can. Like for me, and I know I've talked about this before, when I first released my paid app, it was like 99 cents because I figured that's what it's worth, right? But people were paying, so now it's like, I think it's $2.99 or $3.99. So it was just always us, you know, raising it up, bringing it back down, raising it up. And I get fewer downloads, fewer purchases, but the revenue is slightly higher. It's kind of around the same point. So I've tried to bring it down a little bit, see if it goes up. You know, try to bring it up a little bit. You know, then it's too high, no one's buying it. Try to bring it too low, lots of people are buying it, but not making as much money. So for me, I think I found a really good price point for that. And that's always, you know, you should always be playing with the price points on that kind of stuff. For me, I think, you know, higher price, less users, but that's just me. So, and then there's the other part of it. Is how much is the app worth to you as a developer or worth to other developers? Like if someone was gonna buy the source code and the brand and everything from you, how much is it worth? You know, every so often I get contacted by someone who wants to buy EarSpy. They want to buy the code and they want to buy the application itself, right? And the thing is, I wish I could say, I just dig my heels in and say, it's not for sale, but, you know, I'll listen. I'll, you know, if they're going to talk Google numbers, you know, I'll listen, right? But it's usually like, they'll say, you know, I'll spend like $5,000 or something on it. And I'll say, yes, it makes like a few thousand a month. So it's worth more than that to me and everything like that. And plus, you know, I've been working really hard on it. But the thing is, like, even the apps that are underperforming, if somebody was gonna offer to pay me that much for them, I would probably still not sell it because I still think they're gonna take on. Like, I have more invested in it, so they're worth more to me than they would be to somebody else. Somebody else would buy it and say, oh, it's not doing well, and they just move on to the next thing. I still have hope, right? And that might be naive considering how crowded the app market is, but you know, I just think they're late bloomers. They just haven't taken off yet. So always still working on those kind of stuff, right? But it makes you think a lot about, you know, how much is the code worth and how much is the application worth? Because one thing is when you look at something like Code Canyon or Chupa Mobile, these places where you just go buy code and reskin it and re-release it, you could buy code for like $50 or $90 or whatever it is, you know, $20, and just reskin it and release it, and it's, you know, pretty good. And a lot of times it's based on it's like a clone of an actual game that's really making a lot of money, but you know, it's just, but the code is not worth that much. It's funny when you think about it. See, a lot of clients that I talk to, they're really worried about security. I mean, as you would be, you know, they don't want anyone stealing their code. Like, I wouldn't want anyone stealing my code. You know, it's a standard thing, but you know, when we say we outsource things, everything, one of the questions I always get is, how do I know they're not just gonna take my code and release it on their own? And one of the things I have to say is that it's not just the code, it's the brand, it's getting behind it and pushing it and everything like that. I used to make this analogy when I was talking to clients, saying if somebody came to you and they had like a CD-ROM or a DVD or whatever it was, and they had all the source code for Facebook, and they were able to just hand it over to you and say, here's Facebook, you could release your own Facebook now, and you got that, you know, how much would you pay for it? Because to me, it would be worth nothing, because Facebook is more than just the code, it's the brand, and it's the notoriety, and it's, you know, when I think about when I released this app, it wasn't just the app and the code and the icon and the artwork, whatever, it's also all those years of trying to get people to find it, trying to get people, you know, tweaking this and that and the other thing, and all the hours put into it, all the hopes and dreams, and, you know, we need to make this stuff work. And I put the same amount of work into other apps that haven't really taken off, but, you know, I haven't given up on them yet. But there's all this stuff behind it. I like to think that, you know, sometimes you think if you had a time machine and you went back and you just, if I had a time machine and I went back to 2002, I would start Facebook, right? But it's not that easy. It had to be the right person at the right time in the right place, all that kind of stuff. So, you know, the app. So that's why I'm not quite sure how to answer what my app is worth. If I was a real, true, proper businessman, and I've talked about my insecurities there before. If I was a true, proper businessman, I'm sure I would have some sort of algorithm or whatever. I'd be able to tell you it's worth this much based on how much revenue it makes and all this kind of stuff. But to me, it's worth a lot. My apps are worth more to me than they are to somebody else. Now, if somebody comes and starts talking millions, then, you know, dude, you know, I'll bend, you know, I'll give in. But yeah, for now, you know, my apps are worth a lot. So let me ask you guys, how much are your apps worth? I suppose if I was just doing reskinning, my apps wouldn't be worth a lot. I mean, I would buy something for $100 or £100 or whatever, and if it made $300, then that would be and that would be good. But if it didn't, then it would be a loss and all this kind of stuff. But to me, it's a lot more that goes into it, there's also other intangible things, like when we do client work, a lot of that stuff is just portfolio work. It might not be doing a lot on the app stores, but the artwork and everything, it works well as a portfolio application. A lot of times when I talk to clients, I say, we've done a similar app to this, and I could point to it, even though it might not have the downloads and everything that I hoped it would at the time. So anyway, Bart, I hope that helps a little bit. I know it's not the greatest answer. Let me know, what do you guys think? How much is your app worth? If somebody came to you, what is the price that you would give it up for, right? Would you just say, as long as it's more than I'm making now, do you still have those hopes and dreams behind it and think, no, this just hasn't taken off yet. This is my baby. This is going to work. So anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.